Good morning children, welcome to the online class. Today's our topic is Europe. It is one of the continent among all the continents. We will see the location of Europe. In the north side, the Arctic Ocean. In the west side, Atlantic Ocean. In the south side, Mediterranean Sea. And the east side, Ural Mountains. These are the boundaries of Europe. And in this, some landforms are there. Landforms will be there, no? Mountains, plateaus, and plains. And rivers also will be there, no? Then mountains. The Alps and what the famous mountains, which are Alps and Caucasian mountains, are in Europe. And when come to the plateau region, there is a not much plateau region, but whereas plains also not more. And rivers in this Europe are Rhine, Volga, Dnieper, all these rivers. And among these rivers, some of the rivers flow towards the Caspian Sea also, and some in North Sea. And some rivers flow some different countries, through different countries also it flow. Okay, now we will see peninsulas, gulfs, and bays. Peninsulas, gulfs, and bays. If a land which is covered by water on three sides, we call it as a peninsula. That's why only we call India is also a peninsula, because our India is surrounded by water on three sides. If we observe this Europe also covered with the three sides water only. In this, we take one best example of this is Italy. Italy. We know Italy. That Italy is also a peninsula. Norway and Sweden also peninsulas. What are the examples of peninsulas? Peninsula. Italy. It is penetrated into Mediterranean Sea. Italy, Norway, and Sweden also peninsula only, peninsular countries only. Next, if we come, this is about the peninsula. Then, a land which is covered by water on all the sides, then we call it as a island. Is it right? Island. Island is a land, is a part which covered by water on all the sides. The best example in this continent is Great Britain. Great Britain is surrounded by water. Okay, Great Britain. Great Britain. And now we will see what is a gulf and bay. Okay, we peninsula, a land part which is surrounded by water, we told, and island on all the sides. If a water body which is enclosed by land on three sides, that we call it as a gulf and bay. Gulf and bay. Land part, a water part which is covered by or enclosed by three sides with the land, we call it as a gulf and bay. This bay, when come to the part of bay, it is a water body which is enclosed by land on three sides and with a wide mouth. with the wide mouth. Then we, that means it is in the shape of this. Then we call it as a bay. The best example, it is a Bay of Bengal. What is the eastern boundary to our country? Bay of Bengal. That also in the shape of this only. Whereas Gulf. Gulf is also a water body which is enclosed by three sides water. Sorry, three sides land, but it is a narrow. That means it is not that much. It will be in the shape of this. Narrow mouth. This gulf and bays are suitable for the construction and for the building of harbors. Because this gulf and bays are protected from the storms, protected from the gigantic waves. So these gulf and bays are suitable for the construction of dams. Because for the ships anchoring, for the anchoring of ships, we need deep water. In gulf and bays, it is possible. So most of the beaches, most of the shipping harbor, most of the harbors, they are located in gulf and bays. Next, come to the part of climate. We will come to the part of climate. If we want to compare the climate of Europe with India, it is somehow colder than our country only. Because it is somehow far away from the equator, we know that. The area or the zones which are away from the equator, it will cooler only. It will be, there will be cooler only. If we go to the polar regions, the areas will be very cool. They are covered with snow also. Here, some of the areas, they experience snowfall also. They experience snowfall also. But in our country, we won't experience that snowfall except in Himalayan region. Because our India is very close to the equator and also it is in tropical belt only. Half is in tropical belt and half is in temperate belt. But whereas it is far away from the equator. So the distance from the equator also play a key role in the climate. Next part, Atlantic Ocean. What is there in the west side of this Europe? Atlantic Ocean. This Atlantic Ocean is also impacts. The impact of that Atlantic Ocean is also on the climate of Europe. Because we know that the areas which are very close to the sea, they are somehow warmer than the areas which are far away from the sea. The monsoon winds move from the Atlantic Ocean and it affects the Western Europe. If we compare with the Eastern Europe, somehow Western Europe is a warmer. And in the Central Europe and Eastern Europe, they face snowfall in the winter season. But Western Europe somehow warmer than Eastern Europe. And one more plays a key role, that is the westerlies. These westerlies most from Atlantic Ocean only, and it affects the climate of Europe. And the remaining topic we will discuss in the next class. Thank you, children.